Subscribe to Rajshree Food and click on the bell icon for more updates.
Singhada is actually the Bengali samosa. Hey guys, it's Varun Namdar and welcome to Rajshree Food. Let's make singhadas. So let's first begin with the stuffing, for which I'm going to heat a kadhai or a wok on high flame. And to this, we're going to add in desi ghee. Well, desi ghee, because this is going to be the primary flavor of the singhada. Once the ghee just kind of begins to heat up and is not hot as yet, I'm going to add in red chilies. Well, you can just take dried red chilies, just break it into 2-3 pieces and there you go. The next ingredient is panch poran, or panch poran as we call it. And this is actually equal quantities of fenugreek seeds, fennel seeds, mustard seeds, cumin seeds, and kalonji or onion seeds. Well, traditionally, instead of cumin seeds, they also use something called rodhuni, which are celery seeds. If you can lay your hands on that, well, your panch poran is complete there. To this, I'm going to add in crushed potatoes. When I say crushed potatoes, these are potatoes which are boiled, peeled, and hand crushed. Let's give this a toss. And while this is still kind of cooking in the masalas and the spices, I'm going to add in a few more spices. To begin with, turmeric powder, followed by garam masala powder. Well, of course, if you can lay your hands on Bengali garam masala, which is a mix of some sweet spices, then you can add that by all means. But this one is just garam masala. Let's add in the coriander leaves. The final ingredient to this is, of course, salt as required. Well, if you've added salt while boiling the potatoes, you need to be careful at this point in time. But otherwise, just salt it as per the requirement. A toss, and allow this mixture to just cook in all of these spices for somewhere around 5 to 7 minutes on medium to low flame. Well, the singhada mixture is done and ready. If you want to make changes or variations to this recipe, by all means, you can add in a lot of ginger, which of course a lot of Bengalis love in a singhada. You can add in peanuts, you can add in green peas, which are boiled and ready, and just mix it up, make your own versions of singhada, and just go absolutely experimental. With this, off goes the flame, and your mixture needs to cool down completely. And while this is cooling down, let's start making the outer covering of the singhada or the Bengali samosa. So let's do that. For the outer covering, I'm going to use refined flour. And this goes straight on the working table. Create like a well or an indent in the center. And to this, I'm going to add in the remaining amount of desi ghee. And desi ghee is added so that it becomes nice khasta and short crust. Let's give all of this a mix with your fingers to begin with. Once refined flour kind of becomes like breadcrumbs, we'll be adding in salt as well. This time the salt is only as much as required for the pastry, because of course the potato filling has its own quantity of salt. Mix this well, and at this stage, create another well and let's add in cold water. Well, do not get tempted to add in a lot of water in a single go. Absolutely slow and steady. All you need is a stiff dough. A stiff dough is kneaded and ready. Let's bring all of this back and rest it under a damp cloth for 15 minutes. Two of our components are done and ready. Of course, the stuffing is ready and the outer coating or the covering is ready. Let's move on to the third and the final component, and that is shaping this and frying this. So for that, we need to roll this into a thin cylinder and let's cut these into smaller pieces. Well, singhadas are generally smaller size samosas. They're also known as cocktail samosas. Possibly that's where the name comes in from. Let's roll this into a smaller bit, and without the use of flour or oil, we need to roll this into a thin disc. Well, because of the refined flour, this is kind of going to pull back, and that's the kind of pressure you need to apply and roll it like so. Cut it midway and take it on your fingers like this. You take two ends of the samosa patty and bring them together like this, creating a pocket which is triangular like so. Take a little bit of the mixture, a little smaller than the size of a lemon, bring it like so together and push it right in the center. Apply cold water on the sides of the singhada and bring this together like so. Press the sides and ensure that the mixture is well secured. Create this as a base and place it like so. Well, similarly, you need to start making all of the singhadas. If you wish to keep them in the refrigerator, you can keep them at this stage and fry them when you have guests in your house. Well, it's extremely important to have it sealed completely from all ends and all edges because you don't want any of the filling or stuffing to kind of release while frying in oil. With this, our singhadas are shaped and ready. We need to give one final pinch before dropping these singhadas in oil, and that's only to ensure that they're nice and pinched perfectly from all sides. And these then need to be fried on medium to low flame for at least 15 minutes till they're nice, crisp and golden brown in color. Our singhadas are golden fried, crisp and ready. Let's pull these out of the oil and drain these on an absorbent tissue paper. These are now ready to go on the table. Well, on that note, whether you wish to have it for breakfast or for evening snacks, the recipe is all yours now. On that note, do not forget to like and share the video and subscribe to Rajshree Food.